So you went to the range with your Labradar unit, and you recorded two shot series. The first one was using a projectile weight of 60 grains, and the second one was for a projectile weight of 160 grains. So you finished, you packed everything up, you came home, you downloaded the files to your computer, and you started looking at them. You then realized that for the second shot series, you forgot to change the projectile weight from 60 to 160. So your entire second series was recorded using the incorrect projectile weight. Does this mean you need to go back out to the range and re-record that series? No. In this video, we're going to show you how to correct the data when you accidentally use the wrong projectile weight. Here I've got the workbook opened. It has a quick review. This will be your Labradar unit serial number. This is the shot series number, the total number of shots. This is our unit of measure legend. All velocities are in feet per second. Distances are in yards. Kinetic energy is in foot-pounds force. Weight is in grains. Now, for the purpose of this video, what I've added these headings because these velocities are the ones for the distance we set at DX1, these for DX2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, what I did on purpose on this series, I intentionally shot the first 19 shots using a projectile weight of 60, but I went into preferences and set the projectile weight to the correct weight of 160. So for all 29 shots, the bullet actually weighed 160 grains, but I wanted to show the differences in these numbers when it changes over from 60 to 160. If you look at velocities, you see there's really no difference as you transition from the 60 to 160. That's because velocity is dependent on distance, not bullet weight. Your velocities are going to be just fine. The other set of numbers we have is kinetic energy, as you can see, kinetic energy is just in the double digits until we hit the 160s, and then it goes into triple digits. So kinetic energy is dependent on bullet weight. So all these numbers here are incorrect because the bullet weight was actually 160. Take a look at the third set of numbers, which is power factor. As you can see, power factor here is in the 40s when the weight was recorded at 60, but then it jumps it up into the low 100s when the correct weight was used. So these numbers here are incorrect, and so these need to be fixed. So the kinetic energy numbers need to be fixed, and the power factor numbers need to be fixed. And we're going to see how to do that. Well, the first thing we're going to do is for the incorrect kinetic energy numbers, we're going to highlight them, and we're going to set the number of decimal places to zero, because when we input a formula, it's going to calculate out to however many decimal places there are, and we really don't need to see that many. So we highlight it, right-click it, format cells, number, decimal places, zero. Now, we're only going to do this kinetic energy because we're going to do something different for power factor. Now, we're going to enter in a formula to give us the correct kinetic energy. As you may recall, any formula in Excel begins with the equal sign. So, on the left-hand side, you see the formula we're going to use. It's weight times velocity squared divided by the constant 450436. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to explain where I came up with that constant. So, to get weight, we're going to highlight the column and cell that contains the projectile weight. And you can see in this case, it's 0.18. Now, we're going to take this formula and we're going to move it all over this place. So as we move it, we want the reference to velocity to change. But for projectile weight, as we move the formula, while we want the row to change, we do not want the column to change. We always want it to be column O. So at this point, we're going to press F4, and you can see that Excel put a dollar sign in front of the O and a dollar sign in front of the 18. This made this an absolute reference. It won't change as you copy this formula around. The problem is we want the column to be absolute, but not the row. So let's press F4 again. It's still not what we want. So let's press it again. Now we have it the way we want it. The column is absolute. The row is not. So we've got our weight now. The formula is times velocity squared. So we're entering an asterisk for multiplication. This kinetic energy is at distance 0, so we highlight the velocity under V0. Now we have to square it, which on my keyboard is shift number 6, which gives a caret, and then 2. Okay, that is telling Excel to square the number in the cell B18. Now we want to divide it by the constant, so the division symbol, and 450436, and then enter. Okay, now it's still that number 68 because we haven't changed the projectile weight, but we're going to do that in a little bit. So what we're going to do now is drag this formula across the row. And before I release the mouse, I'm looking at the numbers, and I could see that one of them changed, but not by much. And that's okay. I'm then going to click, hold, and drag down. And while still holding, kind of look at the numbers and let go. And some of the numbers change here, but not by much. That tells me that my formula is pretty good. Now, before we change the projectile weight, let's fix the power factor formula. Now, the document we're looking at is the USPSA rule books for 2019. And here it is showing you the formula for power factor. It's bullet weight in grains times average velocity in feet per second divided by 1,000. Very simple formula. It says the final result will ignore all decimal places. In other words, if it calculates 124.9999, that's not a power factor of 125. It's a power factor of 124. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the Excel integer function that strips away decimal places and wrap it around this formula. So you click in the power factor cell, you type the equal sign, then int, that's the integer function, parentheses. Now we're going to enter in the power factor formula, which is projectile weight times velocity. In the Labradar unit, the velocity that is used for the calculation of power factor is dx1. That's in your preferences. You set 5 distances. The first one you set is dx1. So this is my dx1. So I get that velocity, and then it's divided by 1,000, and then I close parentheses and enter. All right, let's see how well the formula looks. This is 46.98. So per the rule book, this is a power factor of 46, not 47. So let's make sure this formula gives us 46. And it does. So now we're going to go ahead and just drag it down all the way. And if you want to, you can just drag it for the complete set of power factor numbers. That way you'll get rid of all these decimal places. Okay, so now we have the correct formulas in for kinetic energy and power factor. Now we are ready to correct the projectile weight, which is 160. So I'm going to click, drag it all the way down, so it changes my projectile weight to 160. Now we have the corrected kinetic energies and power factors for our workbook. Now, if you watch the other videos or are familiar with the Labradar files, you know down in the tracking folder, you have all these individual shots. Do we need to change anything in here? Well, let's take a look. And again, it shows your serial number, the shot series, the shot, the time it was taken, the velocity, the distance, and the signal-to-noise ratio. As you can see, weight is not in here anywhere, because velocity is not dependent on projectile weight. So there's nothing to fix in the individual tracking workbooks. So at this point, we're done. Now, for those of you who want to know where I got the constant 450436, this explains the process of where I came up with it. I won't go into detail because most people probably are not interested in all the detail, but for those that are, I suggest you just pause the video and read through it, and it should hopefully explain to you where I came up with the constant. For everyone else, I hope this video was useful to you, and thank you for watching.